Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing how to replace the battery in this HP Gaming Pavilion. This laptop is about 5 years old and actually hasn't been used in the last year and a half. And now my son decided to take up PC gaming, so he's going to be using this laptop for a while. So I thought it was pretty much due for a battery change. So in this video, I'm going to show pretty much how to do a step-by-step guide on how to replace it properly. Well, I hope it's properly. I've never done this myself, so this is going to be a learning experience. So other than that, let's just jump right into it. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is show you how to properly identify what battery is in your laptop. And this is going to be the same process as when you're going to actually replace it as well. So pretty much the same teardown method, but there are a couple things you need to do before you start messing around with the internals of your laptop. And the first thing is you want to make sure your power cable is not plugged in. And then you want to go through the process of properly shutting down your laptop, because you do not want any electricity flowing through it while you're kind of messing around with the internals. That could end badly. So I only need two tools to tear down my laptop. And the first is a Phillips head screwdriver. And then the bit on here is a 00. So other than that, I just need this little pick as well to help remove the back cover, and that's pretty much it. So these are from an iFixit kit, and it's just an essential iFixit kit, which I pretty much use to do all my PC related teardowns and stuff like that. I'll leave a link down in the description, but if you don't want to buy that, sometimes when you do buy replacement batteries, they do send screwdrivers that could be used for your laptop, and they also throw a pick in there as well. So just keep that in mind when you're actually buying the replacement battery. Okay, so now I'm going to remove the back panel so I have access to the battery. So I'm going to flip over the laptop. So I have 7 screws that hold on this back panel. I got 4 in the back and 3 in the front. Well, I only have actually 2 in the front now, because the last time I had this open, I misplaced this one. So, oh well. So I'm going to take my Phillips head screwdriver and then just start removing these screws. Okay, since I have all my screws out now, I'm just gonna turn the laptop around. I found it the easiest to get into my laptop by going by the exhaust vent right here and then taking the pick and then kind of just slide it in there and then move it along just to pretty much pop off the back panel. And then eventually at a point, it should just pop off just like that. Okay, so here is the battery within my laptop. So now I'm going to give you 2 different reference numbers you can use to pretty much order a replacement battery. And the first one is actually right down here. So this is the number that HP actually gives you to replace your battery with. So it says replace with HP spare, and then it has this L48495-005. So you would just take HP Gaming Pavilion and you would put that number into like Google or Amazon, and then you should come up with a bunch of different results on batteries you can use for this. And then the other number is, let me zoom up over here, I would take HP Gaming Pavilion and then take this number right here, this PG03XL, and do the same concept, and you can get a bunch of different results for replacement batteries. Okay, so after you receive your replacement battery and you're ready to swap it out, the first thing is you want to do is you want to disconnect the battery from the motherboard. And there's a little cable right here, if it will actually focus, and it connects into the motherboard right here. So I'm just going to pop this cable out. Try not to block it too much, and I disconnect it from there. Okay, so after you have your battery unplugged, you just want to flip the laptop over. Just trying to be gentle since it's exposed on the bottom. And then I'm going to open it up. I need to discharge the laptop to make sure there's no electricity built up in there. So all I'm going to do is hold down the power button for a couple seconds, and that should get rid of any electricity that happens to be in the motherboard, just so I don't short circuit anything like that. And then I can close this back up and then flip it back over. Okay, so all I gotta do now to remove this battery is pretty much take these 4 screws out. I got 1 right here, I got 1 right here, and then I got 2 on the ends right here. So all I'm going to do is just take my screwdriver and unscrew those. I'm trying to keep my hands out of the way of the camera, but it's a little more difficult than I thought. Okay, so those are all out. So this should be able to, yep, just comes right out like that. I'm just gonna set this off to the side for now. Okay, so here is the spare battery. So it is pretty much identical other than they took some tape and it looks like they covered the HP logo up. As you can see right here, HP logo up in the corner. And then it looks like some black electrical tape. I'm actually gonna peel that off just because I think that's kind of funny. Taped very good, yep. As you see, electrical tape over the HP logo. That's kind of funny. So I'm just gonna throw that off to the side. So I'm gonna take my new battery and actually just put it in position. Line it up with the screw holes there. So I'm gonna take the four screws and actually screw it back down. So one at a time. Okay, so now I'm at the point where I can connect the cable back up to the motherboard of the laptop, and I'm just gonna slide that back in there. Actually, I gotta bend it a little bit to get it to fit properly. I'm gonna push that in, then I'm just gonna use my screwdriver just to make sure it is pushed in all the way. Okay, so now I'm gonna flip over the laptop and pretty much power it on just to make sure everything is working properly. I'm gonna go on the other side because my mic's kinda in the way right now. Okay, moment of truth, did I mess up? I see a green light, that's a good sign. Give it a couple seconds to boot up. Looks like everything is working properly, that's really good. Okay, other than my battery is running low, so I gotta plug it in and let it charge. Why am I using my mouse for this one? I don't know. Bad habits on my desk. Okay, I guess other than that, this is pretty much done. I'm gonna keep that, I'm gonna keep this battery for a little bit longer, just in case if there is any issues with this battery, I will have a backup. But probably after a while, I will have to find a place to properly recycle this, and that's pretty much it. So I'm gonna power this down and put the back cover back on because it is still off. But other than that, this is pretty much complete. So that's gonna be it for today's video, and I hope you enjoyed. And if you did, please drop a like, make sure you're subscribed to the channel for more content. And also if you wanna see another video on how to clean laptop fans, that video will be linked here in a couple seconds. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.